Way before the battle came the Warriors' journey.
I always wanted to play in the NHL, and
I don't think I realized where the game would take me.
Knowing what it means to put that jersey on, you're wearing that crest, that means you're the best and never be content.
For 19, 20 years in the National Hockey League, I used to fight people. Now I'm a figure skater.
The way I played hockey throughout my career, play tough, be physical, I probably would have never in a million years thought I'd be figure skating on a live TV show.
From the elite level of their game, they now struggle to learn this game. Enlightenment starts with respect.
I'm pissed that I didn't learn how to figure skate 20 years ago because I would have been a much better hockey player.
You don't appreciate how difficult it is. Their athletic ability is second to none.
Shoot. We're throwing everything into that program.
We're going to be full throttle from here on out. There's no sense saving anything.
Stand up tall.
I've never done anything like this in my life. It's like being stuck out on a penalty kill for a minute and a half and you can't get off the ice.
We keep getting better, and I think we have the right stuff right now for this week.
Oh, what is she doing?
You could skate the perfect skate today, but it really doesn't matter. Going into Sunday, somebody's going home. Stakes are high.
You just do everything that you can and go all in every single day.
Everybody's stepping it up every week, so make week three as epic as possible.
For me, I want to do something great right away.
The goal is to push it a little bit higher every week.
In this stage of the game now, you have to captivate the audience. Conservative programs, it's probably not enough.
Caution's done. It's week three. Time to be great or be gone.
Put on your best dress, darling. Can't you see the time is right? There will never be another tonight. Hey! Come on! You got your
Let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen, for the seven remaining pairs still standing, still gliding in Battle of the Blades, right there. Middle age sucks. Hi, everyone. As you can see, I'm flying solo this week because Ron is in Winnipeg to watch the Jets take off yet again. Great, it's very cool. But right here at the MasterCard Center in Toronto, well, our seven pairs each have a brand new solo for you. Our theme tonight is the beat, which means that much of the attention will be placed on footwork. It's all about the rhythm and the feeling of the music. Tonight, our top seven will all skate, and tomorrow, two teams will go head to head to try to impress our judges and avoid elimination. So, speaking of judges, let's meet them. Up first, she's choreographed for the very best in the world, and she's done a few programs for myself as well. Miss Sandra Bezick. And a little bit of business here. Jeremy Roenick had some travel issues this afternoon. His aircraft was grounded in New York, so stepping in is the one, the only, the Canadian and world champion, Mr. Paul Martini. Nice. And our guest judge this week is a two-time Stanley Cup winner, and he's the president of the NHL Alumni. Please welcome Mark Napier. Welcome, Mark. Sandra, if I may ask you, I'm very curious. The footwork is the priority for the hockey players this week. How do you think that'll change their game plan?
You know, it's interesting. Brian Berard said something to me that stopped me actually today, because he mentioned that up until this week, everything's been about large muscle groups with all the lifting, and this week they had to pay attention to all the small muscle groups. He said he's hurting in places he never knew he had. So this is, I think, is very demanding for them, not only physically, but then also mentally, because there's so much detail in footwork, and I think this is a completely new experience for our players. It'll be exciting to see what happens.
I like the challenge, I do. Paul, this is a new situation for you too. You've been in the trenches with these guys for the past 2 years, this year as well. This must feel like you're jumping ship to the other team.
Well, I don't know if I've jumped ship to the other team, but I certainly hope I've gained the respect of all eight of the players that have been with us in this Battle of the Blades. I must say I've been had the opportunity to work with them all at some point over the past 8 weeks. And I think as a show, we've been aggressive this week, because to take this move, to go to Beat Week this early, has been a huge challenge. And I cannot tell you how hard the players and the teams have worked to get their material ready today. It's been tough.
And nobody knows it better than you. You've been in right every day with them. Mark Napier, it's awesome. I think the players from the NHL alumni have impressed the whole world with what they've done here. You must be very proud.
Very proud of them. Actually, I have the greatest job in the world. I get to represent the greatest athletes in the world. They raise millions of dollars for charity, and I think over $1 million off of this show alone, correct? So. But what I'm really proud of is they when they have the equipment off, they've shown people what great athletes they are, and also as role models to step out of your comfort zone. It's easy when you put the pads on and get out in the ice, but to go and do this, it shows a lot of kids all around the world that take a chance and go do it.
Yeah, pretty inspiring stuff. Good words. All right, well, let's get it going. Our theme this week is the beat, and setting it up is Paul Martini.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, hey.
Week 3 for Battle is Beat Week. This is the week where the teams finally get to be held musically accountable. They're all going to get music that's got a very definitive beat that they have to stay in time with. And so we're going to find out if they've got rhythm, if they've got timing, if they can stay in true sync with their partners.
1, 2, 3.
And just to complicate matters a little bit more, they've actually got to execute some legitimate footwork.
And pump, 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 pump.
Oh, jeez. Oh, it's fast for me. Holy man.
I think this week could be a separator in terms of who's got it. Who has timing, rhythm, musicality, connection with their partner, and get the audience into it.
Let's get right to our programs. After week one, they sat at the very bottom of the judges' leaderboard. But they bounced back to have the best performance last